As we have discussed the capacity and efficiency of group of piles, we are now set to determine the consolidation settlement of group of piles. The consolidation settlement of a group pile in clay can be estimated by using the 2:1 stress distribution method, which is 2 vertical:1 horizontal. So here are the step-by-step process in determining the consolidation settlement of group piles. The step 1 is to let the depth of embedment of the piles be L. The group is subjected to a total load Q. And if the pile cap is below the original ground surface, that Q equals to the total load of the superstructure on the piles minus the effective weight of the soil above the group piles removed by excavation. Step number 2. Assume that the load Q, G, is transmitted to the soil beginning at the depth of 2L:3 from the top of the pile as shown in the figure. So if this is your full length of your pile, L, so we will start that stress distribution at a length 2/3. Okay, 2/3 from the top of the pile. So 2/3 from the top of the pile where it is connected on the pile cap. So 2/3 of that length, which is right here. So this will be the starting point where we will spread a 2 vertical:1 horizontal stress distribution for that particular load, QG. So now after that, we proceed to step number 3. Calculate the increase in effective stress caused at the middle of each soil layer by the load QG. So the formula in determining that increase in effective stress is this one. So what are these values, the VG, LG, and ZI? So VG, LG, these are the length and width respectively of the plan group piles. Well, ZI is the distance from Z0 to the middle of the clay layer. So it is simply equivalent to the force UG divided by the equivalent area being spread at the mid-height of the clay layer. So given this figure right here, we have two clay layers, so it is possible that we can determine two consolidation settlements. But say, we are just going to determine the consolidation settlement along the clay layer 3. So, from step 2, we have identified the 2/3 length of the pile from the top as the starting point where the stress distribution will be spread up to the mid-height of this clay layer number 3. So, as we determine the stress, that area at the starting point at 2/3 length, which is based from the equivalent block of a group pile, which is right here at the top figure, okay, which has a rectangular dimension formed with BG and LG as their dimensions. So that dimension will be spread by a slope of 2 vertical:1 horizontal here at mid-height. So that area becomes bigger and we have additional dimension from its initial dimension BG and LG. So when we have a depth ZI where our Z at 0 is right here at the point of starting point, and at any point Z, and since we are required in determining the consolidation settlement at the mid-height of that particular soil layer, so if this is your vertical distance, which is using the slope 2 vertical:1 horizontal, so that equivalent horizontal distance being obtained is 1/2 of that one half of that vertical spread. So this will be ZI over 2. So the other one is ZI over 2. So it means that the total dimension when we already have a spread in stress or the spread in area for this particular load at mid height, so the dimension required now for the area for this dimension, let's say this one is the LG, is equivalent to LG plus ZI over 2 plus ZI over 2. So adding ZI over 2 plus ZI over 2 is just equivalent to 1 half plus 1 half, which is equals to 1. So that will be LG plus ZI. So this will be the equivalent dimension for that. And the other one, BG, spreading it again where the slope of 2 vertical is to 1 horizontal, that dimension will just have an additional dimension of ZI or the same representation as with LG. Okay, so that's why we have a total BG plus ZI when it's spread at a depth where it is located at the mid height of the clay layer number 3. So that's the area that we are going to determine. So that's why we have this BG plus ZI to be multiplied by LG plus ZI, as that serves as your area. So this is your load, this is your area. So this is the equation to be used in determining the effective stress increase on the clay layer. So after that, since we already have determined the increase in stress at the mid height, we can now calculate the approximate total consolidation settlement of the pile foundation at mid height of clay layer using this equation, or simply the solution for primary consolidation of clay. So we need the values for the compression index, the height of the clay layer, the void ratio, the overburden pressure, and the determined increase in effective stress at the mid height of the clay layer. So the same way with the overburden pressure, sigma prime 0, we need to determine the overburden pressure at the mid height of the clay layer. So we need to determine that also. So using this equation, we can determine the primary consolidation settlement of group piles. So now let's start solving some sample problems. For our first example, the 2x2 pile group extends to a depth of 9 meters in the soil profile shown. The group load is 540 kN, or it is equivalent to 135 kN for each pile. The individual 0.45 meter in diameter piles are spaced 0.6 meter on center. Knowing that the group action is occurring, determine the following: the specific gravity of the silty sand, the saturated unit weight of the silty sand, and we'll determine the approximate settlement of the piles if the water table elevation remains unchanged. So here, this figure, we have here a 540 kN load to be distributed on the soil layer, and we will determine the approximate settlement. But first, we have unknown values such as the specific gravity of this silty sand, which starts from here up to this layer. Now, given that we have a water table here at a depth 3 meters from the surface, so it means that this layer right here is fully saturated, and while this one is dry. Now, given here is water content of 17% for the saturated layer, of the citizen. So let's determine first what will be the equivalent specific gravity of this citizen. So let's answer now. For number one, let's determine the specific gravity. Okay, so we have given, we have a dry unit weight of the silty sand, 16.2 kilonewtons per cubic meters. So for the water content for this layer, which is still a silty sand layer, but only saturated, the water content is 17%. Okay. So where will we take advantage of these given values alone? So from the formula of a dry unit weight has a formula that we can use of G over 1 plus E equals to unit weight multiplied by the unit weight of water. So E is void ratio, G this is the required. So we have two unknowns here, but we can derive the value, or we can derive this equation with two variables. So we can substitute given values for the dry unit weight of the silty sand. Okay, so silty sand. And we have G. Don't have void ratio, but you can have the unit weight of water, which is 9.81 kilonewtons per cubic meters as our standard unit weight of water. So let's now multiply both sides by 1 plus E to eliminate this denominator. So what will happen is we have 16.2 kilonewtons per cubic meters is multiplied by 1 plus E equals to G times 10.81 kilonewtons per cubic meters. Okay. So next, we divide both sides by 9.81 kilonewtons per cubic meter to isolate this specific gravity, which is the required. So dividing both sides by 9.81 to eliminate this value at the right hand side of the equation, then have this E over 9.81 kilonewtons per cubic meter is equals to G. Okay, so let's simplify by dividing 16.2 by 9.81. Okay, 16.2 over 9.81, that would be 1.651. Okay, the unit will be cancelled out. 1 plus E is equal to G. So this will be our first equation. For our second equation, we can use the equation of the moisture content of the soil layer, or of the soil, is multiplied by the specific gravity of the soil. That will be equals to the degree of saturation multiplied by void ratio. So this is another equation that we can use in deriving the solution in order to eliminate one variable. So considering this as silty sand layer, where we have here water content of 17%, so in a soil layer that is fully saturated, the degree of saturation for that will be 100%. So the void ratio is a null. But since this layer is the same type of soil, which is a silty sand, their specific gravity are the same. So using this equation, given that we have a water content of 17% and specific gravity that is equals to the degree of saturation of 100% is multiplied by the void ratio. So this is another equation where we can substitute the value of the void ratio in terms of specific gravity. So dividing both sides by 100%, so 17/100. Multiplied by g. So now it means that the void ratio is 0.17 times g. This is your equation number 2. So we substitute now the equation number 2 here in equation 1 in order for us to determine the value of the specific gravity. So in equation 1, we have 1.651. 1 plus e equals to g. So substitute, where we have 1 plus 0.17 g is equals to g. So we only have one variable left. Then let's determine the value of g. So I'll just directly solve this using my calculator. Let's determine the variable g. Okay, so the specific gravity now is 2.295. Okay, that is unit less. But we can also check. We can also check without, or we can also solve this without rounding off, because we have rounded up 1.651, which is 16.2/9.81. Okay. 2.296 to be exact, without rounding off. 2.296. Okay. So that's the answer for question number 1. Next, let's determine now the saturated unit weight of the silty sand. So we have identified already the specific gravity of the silty sand. We can easily now determine the saturated unit weight of the silty sand using this equation. The specific gravity is added by the void ratio divided by 1 plus the void ratio times the unit weight of water. So we don't have yet the value of the void ratio, but in equation 2, we have derived an equation where it is in terms of g. Using equation 2, we have E is equals to 0.17g, and we substitute now the value of g, which is 2.296. Therefore, the void ratio is 0.039. Now, the saturated unit weight is equals to 2.296 plus 0.039 all over 1 plus 0.039 times 9.81 kilonewtons per cubic meters. So the saturated unit weight is equals to 2.296 Okay, 22.0465. Okay? 22.0465. Okay? Kilonewtons per cubic meters. This is the answer for question number 2. For question number 3 now. Number 3, compute the approximate settlement of the pipes if the water table elevation remains unchanged. Okay, for number 3, solution. So first, if the full length of the pile, your L, is 9 meters, the second step is we identify the 2/3 length of that pile from the top. So the 2/3 of 9 meter is about 6 meters, okay, from the top. So it means that the spread to vertical is to 1 will start right here. The spread of the stress will start here. Okay, stress distribution. So that will be at a distance of 6 meters because that is 2/3 of the length of the pipe. Next, okay, the remaining is 3 meters. So it means that it will spread at a slope of 2 vertical is 2. Okay, that's the last one. And this one. So we will determine the settlement at mid height. Okay, the mid height of this clay layer. So let's say this one is your mid height. Okay. So if this is the section of your pile, we have 4 piles. So it has a distance of 0.6 meters from center to center, but from edge to edge, we have a 1.05 meter. So forming a rectangular, okay, a block formed by this group pile, this will be the shape, rectangle. Okay, this is a square. 1.05 and 1.05. So your LG and BG is just the same. So what will be the ZI or distance from the starting point right here to the mid height? So let's determine that. That distance will be, this is 3 meters, this is 2.4. So the clay layer is 2.4, so this is 1.2 meters. Okay, so if we add this to this is about 11 meters. So if this is 9 meters, we have a remaining distance of 2 meters. So starting here, this is 3 meters plus 2 meters plus 1.2. That will be your ZI. 3 meters plus 2 meters plus 1/2 of the clay layer, 1.2 meters. So that will be 6.2 meters. Okay, so if we just based on our solution, we can already determine the increase in effective stress, okay, later. So the QG is 540 kilonewtons and the ZI is 6.2 meters. So using this equation that we have discussed earlier, we can determine the increase in effective stress. So delta sigma is equals to QG, the concentrated load of 540 kilonewtons is divided by 1.05 meters added by ZI 6.2, 1.05 also added by 6.2 meters. Okay, we have a unit of kilopascal. And then 40 over 1.05 plus 6.2. We just square this because they are the same. 10.273 kilopascal. That's your increase in effective stress. So this is the step 3 of the process of determining the consolidation settlement of group pipe. So in the step 4, they stated there the formula for the consolidation settlement of a group pipe. So settlement now is equals to CCH over 1 plus E logarithm of sigma prime O plus delta sigma prime, this would be your delta sigma prime, over sigma prime O. So sigma prime O is your overburden pressure. So going back, we have given compression index of 0.47 and the void ratio for the clay layer of 0.7. So we can easily substitute it here. H is the clay layer distance, 2.4 meters, but we don't have yet the overburden pressure. So the overburden pressure is just simply the effective stress at the mid height of this clay layer. So to determine the effective stress, just add up the effective unit weights for each layer of this soils above the mid height of the clay layer. Okay. Just multiply the effective unit weight to its equivalent height or depth. So first, let's multiply the dry unit weight of the silty sand to 3 meters. Then add it up to the buoyant unit weight of the silty sand multiplied by 8 meters. And the remaining is the buoyant unit weight also of the clay layer, which is just equivalent to 1.2 meters. Okay, for the buoyant or effective unit weight. First, 16.2 kilonewtons per cubic meter. For the dry unit weight times 3 meters plus the buoyant unit weight or the effective unit weight of the silty sand. Since we have the saturated unit weight of 22.0465, okay, the buoyant unit weight is just the saturated unit weight subtracted by the unit weight of the water. So 22.0465 kilonewtons per cubic meter subtracted by 9.81 kilonewtons per cubic meter is multiplied by 8 meters plus the buoyant unit weight of clay. So we have a saturated unit weight of 15.3. So that 15.3 kilonewtons per cubic meters subtracted by 9.81 kilonewtons per cubic meters multiplied by 1.2 meters. So let's compute it now. 16.2 times 3 plus 1.2. Okay, 153.08 kilopascal. So let me double check. Okay. Okay, as well as the height. Okay. 3 meters, 8 meters, and 1.2. Okay. So next, we substitute all the values here at the general formula. 0.47 times 2.4 meters. If we wanted a meter, but since centimeter is very small, we can convert this into millimeter by multiplying 1,000. Okay. Per 1 meter. Then 1 plus e 0.70 logarithm of 153.08 kilopascal plus 10.273 all over 153.08. So S is, let's just make it 2,400, 1 plus 0.7, logarithm of plus 10.273, 153.08 equals to 18.717 millimeters. So that's your consolidation setup for the clay layer. Okay, so that's how we solve the settlement for group piles.